Good morning, or good evening, good whatever time it may be where you are. Welcome back, finally, to the second episode. It's been so long of Humans of Monroe. I'm your host, Chancey Boyce, and it's been a while. It's been a long time since our very first episode, back about 1 or 2 months ago when I interviewed our lovely, wonderful Winterfest King, a very, very smart and impressive guy, Logan Tucker. Our senior Winterfest King here at Monroe High School. Our podcast today, as you know, is produced by Lotus Leaf, our school newspaper at Monroe High School. And I gotta hand it to the folks at Lotus Leaf. They did an absolutely wonderful job. It's been so long since our first episode. And as you know, as you probably know, the reason it's been so long since our very first episode of Humans of Monroe is because the prevailing circumstances, the coronavirus outbreak, the COVID-19 outbreak, whatever you want to call it. And it's driven us all into our homes. We're under lockdown. You might have heard, if you're a listener of the radio, you might have heard some kind of commercial about how we're living in unprecedented times. We're living in these absolutely, the word that's used a lot of the times is, we're living in uncertain times, you know. Well, it is quite uncertain because I'm not at school. I'm not at Monroe High School. And if I'm not at Monroe High School, I don't have the equipment to record this podcast. But thankfully, thank goodness for the people at Lotus Leaf, the Lotus Leaf school newspaper. They were able to send me a microphone and all the equipment I need to record a podcast. So thank you very much to all the folks at Lotus Leaf, to Miss Droogle and everybody else. Give them a hand. Go and if you can talk to them, if you have any way to contact the Lotus Leaf school newspaper. We have an Instagram account, we have a Snapchat account. We don't have a TikTok, thank goodness. If you have any way to contact the Lotus Leaf school newspaper, give them a thank you for providing the equipment to allow us to record this podcast tonight. So, anyways, I was thinking, about the times we're living in, the uncertain times we're living in, about the crisis that is currently occurring around us. And you know, it is a crisis. There's a lot of people who are suffering very badly right now. But for me, I'm not that worried. I'm not personally worried about myself at all. I'm doing perfectly fine. I get to stay here in my comfy little house and read all the books I want to read and do all the little things I want to do, finish all the school homework assignments I want to finish. I'm thinking to myself, this is a crisis? You're kidding me? I get to watch as much TV as I want. And I figured, I might as well do an episode of the People of Monroe podcast on the sorts of TV I've been watching lately, and the sorts of TV you've been watching lately as a citizen of Monroe, as a student at Monroe High School, what you've been watching, and what I've been watching. Because, I mean, what else do we have to do? So, for me, I've been watching a lot of Seinfeld. I got the box set a couple years ago for Christmas, and I never had any time to sit down and watch Seinfeld. I mean, it's a very time-consuming show. There's so many hours of content of Seinfeld that you can watch. And I'm not even finished with the show yet. It's an incredible show, I gotta tell you. First of all, it's the part of the appeal of Seinfeld, in my opinion, is the aesthetic. They're in New York City, which is a beautiful place. And they're sitting here in a diner. I mean, most of the episodes involve the four characters, George, Jerry, Elaine, and Kramer. And they're, doing their thing and, ridiculous things happen to them. A lot of time they have these characters sitting down in a diner situation, and I love diners. I love diners so much. The appeal of diners, the diner food, the atmosphere of a diner, I love it. It's not just the aesthetic of the Seinfeld show that's so great though. It's the comedy. It's how funny it is. I've never seen a show as funny as Seinfeld. And I'm a fan of The Simpsons too. I've been watching quite a bit of The Simpsons. So there's that. I've been watching both of those shows, and they've been going very, very well for me. I've been having a great time watching those two shows. But I figured I couldn't do a podcast purely on just what I had been watching. So I decided to reach out to some of my friends. Some of the other people who live in Monroe, go to Monroe High School, are lovely, wonderful citizens of Monroe. They're humans of Monroe. And I had to ask them, what have you been watching? What have you been interested in? What have you been, consuming during this period? And I got quite a response. I got a lot of people responding to me, a lot of people talking to me. Abby Atherton says, "I've been watching Grey's Anatomy. It's the kind of show you can watch over and over again and never get tired of it. I started watching it with my mom and sister, and ever since then I loved it." And that's an interesting opinion. I personally could never get into Grey's Anatomy. It's one of those shows where, you watch a TV show. People tell you to watch TV shows all the time if you're a human being. You hear people say, "Watch this TV show, watch that TV show," and you think to yourself, "Well, I'd love to watch that TV show, but I just don't have the time. I've got so much to do. I'm a busy man. I have homework, I have housework, I have other shows to watch that I'm more invested in." But I took a hot minute a couple months ago, before this trying time even began, to watch a single episode of Grey's Anatomy, and I thought for a minute, maybe this will be a good show. Maybe I'll get into it. Maybe I'll watch all the seasons. Maybe I'll be a diehard Grey's Anatomy fan once I'm through with this. And I sit through this entire episode of Grey's Anatomy, and I don't see the appeal to it. I just don't see the appeal to it. I was talking earlier about how I enjoy the Seinfeld aesthetic. I don't enjoy the Grey's Anatomy aesthetic. It seems that the feel of Grey's Anatomy is comparable to, I would say, probably a jewelry commercial from the mid-2000s. And I can see the appeal to Grey's Anatomy as well. It seems like a very compelling show. There's probably some kind of interesting narrative that occurs there. The suspense of a surgery, of a person who might be about to die during a surgery, is gripping. I can appreciate that. But personally, for me, as Chancey Joseph Boyce, I could never get into Grey's Anatomy. And that's my opinion. That's my opinion. You might have your own opinion. If you have your own opinion and you like to voice it about Grey's Anatomy, of course, you can talk to Lotus Leaf Live at Lotus Leaf Live on Instagram and Twitter and Snapchat and all that sort of thing. Kate McLaughlin says, "Trailer Park Boys," she's been watching Trailer Park Boys, "is about three guys trying to make it in the world by doing very illegal things and ending each season in jail. I enjoy this show," she says, "because the characters are interesting and it's a good show to watch when you're sad, because it's funny and intriguing and just frankly laid back." And I get that. Trailer Park Boys is a show that another show that I tried to get into, that I watched one episode of and just didn't get, I just didn't get it that much. And maybe part of it is me to blame. Maybe I was not yet quite completely enlightened as to how to enjoy a show like Trailer Park Boys. It's a very low budget show. It's very on the nose. It's very thrown together, I feel like. But it probably is a very funny show. The reason I tried to watch it is because the whole concept of these three guys going around doing crazy things and then getting arrested by the end of the season seemed like an interesting motif. The idea of a show structured like The Office. If you've never seen Trailer Park Boys, it's the whole concept of the show is that it's kind of like a documentary, a fake documentary. They have these little talking head interviews that all the characters go through, and the camera's very shaky. Like, it's supposed to be like a documentary. These three guys are living through a documentary. And those shows have always appealed to me. I love The Office. I love Parks and Recreation, both of which have that same documentary motif. And I thought maybe I'll enjoy this show, Trailer Park Boys, which has the same motif. And sometimes you're disappointed. Sometimes it just doesn't work out. Mia Duval says, "I like Midnight Gospel, the show Midnight Gospel. It makes me question reality during every second of the show." I had never seen Midnight Gospel before I began interviewing people to make this podcast, and I watched a little bit of the first episode, and it's incredible. It is great. I really like that show. If you've ever watched the Joe Rogan podcast, great, great podcast. The thing I like about it is the laid backness of it. The whole point, by the way, is it's a cartoon about this character who goes through space and goes to different dimensions and interviews people there as if he's doing a podcast. And in the first episode, he goes to an an alternate version of Earth where he interviews a cartoon president of the United States, and there's a zombie apocalypse going on, and they're shooting zombies while just talking to each other. And the laid-backness of it is what really strikes me. It's the casualness with which these people carry out their conversation. It's very fascinating. It's very interesting. I really like it. And I'm going to continue watching it, by the way. It's not one of those shows where you watch the first episode and think, I'm never going to watch this again. It's something that really hooks you and you got to keep going, in my opinion. Judah Bentley says, I've been watching White Collar, about a criminal named Neil Caffey. Coffey? I'm not quite sure. Who is based off of Frank Abagnale Jr. in a movie called Catch Me If You Can, which is based on a true story. He gets caught by an FBI agent named Peter Burke and is offered a job in the FBI for his certain skill set and connections in the criminal world instead of going to jail. It's a good show, he says. I do like shows that are very crime-themed. I'm a huge Martin Scorsese fan. He makes a lot of mafia movies. I watched Goodfellas recently. I watched the Irishman around the time it came out. There's something about the feel of a mafia movie, the undergroundness of it all, the feeling of you're watching the world behind the scenes, you're watching the sausage get made in our society. That's the appealing part of a crime movie. Ashley Rathbun says, I don't really want to admit this, but I've been watching Keeping Up with the Kardashians. There's nothing wrong with watching Keeping Up with the Kardashians. It's an interesting show. There's nothing wrong with watching an interesting show. You're watching drama go on in front of you. It's like watching modern day Shakespeare, I think. It's the suspension of disbelief, the view of something absolutely insane going on in front of you. That's what it is. That's the reason people watched Shakespeare back in the Middle Ages. That's the reason people watched WWE in the 1990s. And everybody makes fun of these people. Everybody makes fun of people when they watch something that's just chaos for the sake of chaos. Everybody makes fun of them, but 2,000 years from now, guess who's going to have the last laugh? It's the people who are watching chaos for the sake of chaos, because Keeping Up with the Kardashians, just like Shakespeare, just like WWE, is going to be studied in school. People in schools are going to be studying Keeping Up with the Kardashians. Ashley's also been binge-watching The Office, which I like. I mentioned earlier in this podcast that I love The Office. I think it's a great show. It's so interesting. The characters. It's a character-driven show. As I mentioned, it's one of those shows where they have a mock documentary feel to it. So it's pretending you're watching a documentary. It's a pretend documentary, that sort of thing. You've got a lot of great characters in that show. And the thing about that is, not only is it a documentary, but because it's a documentary, they make it as realistic as possible. So all the characters in the show are essentially people you've known throughout your life. I mean, everybody's had an annoying coworker. I've never been to work, but I've known students in my own school, Monroe High School, who I was not quite enthralled with. These Dwight Schrute style people, who's a character on The Office. So that's my take on The Office. Great show. A lot of people don't like The Office. I don't know why. I think it's this tendency of people to hate things that are popular. Because why? I don't know. Let's see what other people have to say. We've got one more message. What does Rainey Owens have to say about the shows she's been watching? She's been watching Community, which is about a group of members at a community college who get in loads of trouble. I never watched Community that much. Back when it was airing on NBC, my mom was watching it, and she decided to stop watching it because, and I quote, she felt like it was making her dumber. Which I don't think that's what watching Community, the effect that watching Community will have on you. I think it seems like a really interesting show. It looks like one of those character-driven shows where everybody you know on the show is somebody you've met in real life. And that's the type of show that makes you not dumber, but smarter. So there you go. And this is the type of thing I wanted to start our new podcast with, our new, you know, we can't interview people in person anymore, so why don't we just talk? Why don't we just talk about the things we're living through? Here in my home studio, my lo-fi, low-budget home studio with my little mic that was sent to me by the great people at Lotus Leaf, you know. This is what we're doing now. We're talking. We're having a nice, leisurely, casual time. Talking about the things in life that matter to us most. So, I hope you've all been doing very, very well. I hope you're staying safe in these trying and uncertain times. I hope you're enjoying all the TV shows you've been watching. Is there a TV show you've been enjoying that you didn't hear mentioned during this podcast? Talk to us about it at Lotus Leaf Live on all of our social media accounts. Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, you know the works. So I hope you're having a great day. I hope you're having a great life. And don't forget to keep on the sunny side.